Congratulations on taking your first step towards living in Canada. But is your CR score low? No worries. The Provincial Nominee Program, commonly called as PNP, is a pathway that can get you to Canada even with a low CRS score. I'm happy to let you guys know that I am starting a PNP series explaining how PNP works, eligibility, and who cannot apply for PNP, and also other important factors that are relevant to PNP. Before that, I have a task for you guys. So search for the red button that looks like this, click on it once, and also search for the bell icon that looks like this next to it. Hit on it as well so that you get notified as and when I post videos. Here we go. So, what's in today's video? In today's video, we'll be talking about 1. What is PNP and the list of PNP programs? 2. The step-by-step process for PNP, and 3. The pros and cons of PNP. So guys, let's begin with the map of Canada. Moving on to the screen now.
This is the map of Canada, and there are 10 provinces such as Ontario, Quebec, British Columbia, Alberta, and so on.
The three territories are Northwest Territories, Nunavut, and Yukon. Guys, first let's understand what is PNP. So PNP basically is a provincial nominee program. Each province or territory has its own geography or population or economy. Therefore, each province or territory, they operate their own immigration program. Let me give you an overview about it. So the decisions regarding the Canadian permanent residence is taken at the national level by the federal government. However, the provincial nominee program is nominated by the province to submit an application for PR to the federal government. So I'll explain about the PNP process in detail in a bit. But how does this work? Based on the labor market demand, the province invites you to apply for PNP with respect to your skills or work experience, whatever is in demand. Let me give you an example. Let's pick Nova Scotia. Say there is a requirement for civil engineers. Now, Nova Scotia will come out with a cutoff score that is lesser than the express entry cutoff. But the invitation will be sent only to the civil engineers. So based on this example, guys, I hope you're able to understand about this process a bit better. Now quickly, let's take a look at the list of PNP programs. Moving on to the screen now. So guys, as you can see, these are the list of PNP programs. When it comes to provinces, Quebec has its own immigration program, which is different from the other PNP programs. Further, when it comes to territories, out of 3, only 2 participate in PNP, with Nunavut being an exception. I hope this gives you a rough idea about PNP. So now let's check the PNP steps in detail. So, the first step in the PNP process is you need to create a profile by checking the eligibility, just like how you would create a profile in the express entry process. So, the first step remains same for both PNP and express entry. And guys, if you need some assistance in creating the profile and checking the eligibility, I'll leave a link in the description box below. I have made a detailed video. Please feel free to go ahead and check it. Moving on to step 2. Now, once you have created a profile, you'll be in the same pool as that of the people in express entry. So say for example, you have a PNP that you are interested in. What you'll be doing is you'll go to the website of that particular province and do some learning, gather some information which is available on the website, like the eligibility or the fees, etc. And then you'll be submitting an application to that particular province. Moving to step 3, as and when you submit your application, the province will review your application and nominate you if you are eligible. Now, the province will confirm your nomination electronically. Once you submit the profile, you will contact the province or the territory and give them your express entry profile number and job seeker validation code. I'm assuming you guys are aware what an express entry profile number is. So it is simply a unique number that is given to you after creating your profile successfully in the express entry pool. Job seeker validation code is a 4-digit code that is automatically generated by the IRCC system. Now, this code can be used to identify your express entry profile while you're registering with the job bank or while applying for your PNP programs. So once you provide the Express Entry Profile Number and Job Seeker Validation Code, the province will utilize these to confirm the nomination. Then you will be sent a message to accept or not to accept the nomination. So this was about step 3, guys. Moving on to step 4. In step 4, say for example you have accepted the nomination. You will be receiving a letter in your account that confirms the nomination. Also guys, you will be receiving extra 600 points and then your account will be placed back in the Express Entry pool. Moving on to our step 5, which is our last step. So once you receive those 600 additional points, you will be receiving an ITA followed by your document submission and then you can apply for PR. So the step 5 is similar to the regular method of applying for PR via Express Entry. So guys, this was an overview of the PNP process. Now I'll be coming up with a PNP video every week. So quickly go ahead and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss on the updates. Awesome guys. All this time we spoke about what is PNP, the list of PNP programs and how this PNP process works and the step-by-step process to PNP. So let's talk about the pros and cons of PNP now. Let's talk about the cons first. The PNP program cost is higher than that of the Express Entry program. So applying under the provincial nominee program will cost you around 700 to 1500 Canadian dollar more in application fee than that of the federal program depending on the province. Also guys, the processing time for the PNP program is higher in comparison to the Express Entry program. Moving to the next point, PNP is unreliable. I'm telling you this because in case of Express Entry, there are at least 2 draws in a month. However, in case of PNP, only if there is a demand, the option is open. Otherwise, you need to wait and there is no scheduled time for it. Moving to point 3, in case of PNP, the most important requirement is that you are expected to live in a particular province for a designated amount of time. However, that's not the case in Express Entry. Moving to point 4, Express Entry does not require a job offer. However, in PNP, there are some provinces that demand a job offer. Let's take a look at pros. Since the cutoff score of Express Entry is always higher, say a foreign worker wants to immigrate to Canada, then the PNP programs pave an easy way to PR as compared to the Express Entry. As I told you guys earlier, say you have a low CRS score, say around 400, and you meet all the eligibility criteria of a particular province, and once you're nominated, you will be getting additional 600 points, which will ultimately increase your overall CRS score. Moving to our next point. If you move to bigger cities like Toronto or Vancouver, there will be a lot of competition for the jobs as compared to the province or territories. You never know, you might even end up getting the job quickly. Moving to our third point, cost of living in provinces or territories are low as compared to the bigger cities of Canada like Toronto or Vancouver. I hope this gives you a better understanding about the advantages and disadvantages of PNP. Guys, PNP comes as a blessing for those who have maxed out on their CRS score and have no option left but would want to immigrate to Canada. Having said that, in case of Express Entry, even if you have the slightest chance to improve your CRS score by improving your IELTS test score, I would say please go for it. I would suggest take up your IELTS exam multiple times, maybe once, twice or thrice until you get 8777. That's all I have in today's video guys. I hope you found the video informative. Do not forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel Canada Stories. Until next video, love you guys. Bye bye.